now, ladies and gentlemen, a very special treat. It's time to visit the freaks for a brief sideshow. Be amazed how one man's dream is also his folly. Step up, one and all, and ask yourselves, can we ever truly know what's inside another's heart? Our anarchist wants to see into his would-be lover's heart, while the lawmen want to look-see into the anarchist's heart. Who's running this panhandling show anyway? While the good doctors think they have seen into the major's heart, but that won't happen until later in our show. But for now, let's pan over to downtown for a look at the shooter. And White Collar will thus interrogate Blue. In a little frolic here at the Exposition that goes a little something like this. You'll see the seven wonders and the seven blunders too. The man behind the gun will get the credit that is due. The men who first invented work will work the working man. For if he cannot work him here at the Pan-American, Pan-American, bring along your daughter and your little brother Dan. Sweet Marie and little Mary Ann, and join our little party to the Pan-American.
Woo! blacksmith's helper, blacksmith shop. Did you ever work in Buffalo? Been here before? How long ago?
Only about a year ago.
Any relatives here?
No, sir, I came to see the fall.
President McKinley went to see the falls too.
Is he?
President McKinley, is that who you mean?
Yes, sir.
Speak up, son. Interrogated by the gold district.
$4.50 for my gun. After I shot, they knocked me down and trampled on me. I have always been a good worker. I worked in a wire. Happened to me. If the president dies, I will be hard.
right, Neiman, from the beginning. What country do you come from?
Detroit.
Detroit, Michigan, Michigan.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Where did your parents come from?
My father came from Poland, and my mother was German.
Is Neiman a Polish name? Is Neiman a Polish name? Answer me when I talk to you, Neiman. Damn it, Neiman, you do as I say. Answer me.
You know, Fred.
Answer me.
They will go a lot
you
easier.
You do as I say.
Agree.
You do as I say.
And you do that, sir.
Speak up now, Fred. It's not what Fred.
That's not my real name. It's a name I go by sometimes.
Me.
I once was on strike using my own name. I changed it to Neiman, so I might get work done.
Anything else I should know about your name?
Just means nobody in German.
So who are you?
Vehar, Czolgosz.
How the hell do you spell that?
L-E.
I've got the part, damn it. How do you spell your last name?
A-Z-O-L-G-O-S-Z.
Wonderful, Leo.
It's not.
Something more you'd like to say.
They want to string him up into
that is it.
There must be 10,000 who want to see him fry. They keep yelling for the terrorists. They want their chance with him if they get him. There's no telling what they might do to him.
Let me take extraordinary measures. We'll have to call out all the police in Harthrow. Every man must come into his heart.
Yes, sir, just as you say, sir. Yes, sir, just as you say, sir.
My family.
Did you talk it over with
anybody? I had nothing to do with it.
What did Emma Goldman say?
I was alone.
You went there with the intention of
killing him. I want to say
did you
I was
Leo?
Alone. And
did you Leo?
we come to the culmination of our show, where we will fly to the heights of ecstasy and plunge you to the depths of despair. Finally, for our last act, you will see, as if surgeons yourselves, a heart set open and a soul laid bare. You, ladies and gentlemen, will be witness to this kangaroo court of history. Judge for yourselves. But one more time, for old time's sake, let's sing a simple tune to carry us through the ages.
A little love tale simply told of which each word is true. Its pleasing sweetness touched my heart. It may have charms for you. My banker's fair daughter was winning the lawyer could plead with the best. The arrows of Cupid were many. Do you think I need tell you
I of vigor for having felt your arms about me.
Indeed, I shall hold you again in the bed until arms I have
known. Oh, precious darling, I know you cannot fret more than I did as this has truly found ourselves in San Francisco. And you a grievous infection did have, such that I did fear that I would lose you forever, for such was the doomsday prediction of your caretakers.
But through my perseverance, but through my perseverance,
and my vehement prayer,
tried to kill you. They are burning effigies. and his paramour, am a good man. Why, here's an article first from our president.
I don't understand.
Well, President McKinley was the first president who was ever photographed smiling.
Couldn't help it. Saw Mrs. McKinley coming my way.
The first ever at the Bobby arrived.
Which I thoroughly despised.
The first to have your voice recorded for posterity.
Yes, thanks to Mr. Edison. Whatever happened to his X-ray machine?
Well, the doctors attempted to use it, but they seemed to be a part missing.
I only hope they spared using it on Jumbo the Elephant.
But Jumbo didn't even flinch when they turned on the power. They didn't have enough current.
Is that what they use for the electric chair?
Pursuing duty may not always lead my soul.
paths. Another course may look easier and more attractive, but pursuing duty for duty's sake is always sure and safe and honorable. That is how I have run this country. There must be a constant movement toward a higher and nobler civilization, a civilization that shall make its conquests without resort to war and achieve its greatest victories, achieving the arts of duty, and duty alone shall prescribe the boundary of our responsibility.
The President's condition has somewhat improved. During the past few hours, there is a better response to stimulation. His heart has been freed from pain. Pulse 128, temperature 99.8 degrees.
Thank you. Exposition justifies the expectation of further improvement. He is better than yesterday at this time. Pulse 123, temperature 99.4.
Newspaper, or at least get a cigar.
I am afraid, sir, that I shall have to deny you on both counts.
Please tell me how the country is taking my temporary setback.
Sir, never has the union of the state been joined in such universal accord. I'm wishing for your swift and complete recovery.
What would help my recovery is a good cigar. What would you have me reduced to crocheting like Mrs. McKinley?
She has now crocheted over 3,000 booties for charity, blue or gray.
She knows how I attained the rank of brevet major, surviving 4 long years that forever changed my life. You know, Cortelyou, what would change my life right now is a nice fat cigar.
Sir, you should adhere to the doctor's orders.
Well, never mind then. What's that young book? That young book, Teddy Roosevelt, up to? He proclaimed I had the backbone of a chocolate eclair. What would be good for me right now is a nice thin cigar.
As you said, that worm the litterers shall not be undertaken except for a cause
which will command itself
to God and man.
And Christianize them, and we put the Philippines on the map. Now, for heaven's sake, please get me a cigar.
The president's occupation is grave at this hour. He is suffering from extreme prostration. He responds to simulation. What body? Pulse 125. Respiration 40.
It is useless, gentlemen. I think we all ought to have
dear God in heaven.
your exercise was a short walk or ride beside his wife. Alas, O father, hear our prayer. When this emergency came, the president's constitution could not stand the shock. Help us, O Lord, to send the shock The president's condition is most serious, and it's profound. The end is only a question of time.
Oh,
always swamped with careless abandon, careless abandon. Blow those many years ago, years ago. And played soldier in the doubled forests.
Oh yes, Major. Indeed you did, my love strong, yet tender, guardian, my own true love.
God-fearing man, of the hardy stock that subdued the frontier, subdued the frontier.
I embrace for him.